Welcome back, anybody I'm still watching, to AG Plays Rewrite. And I just did another, well, doing this one right after the last part, because I figured, you know what, I have nothing else to do, so I might as well. And I am, believe it or not, I'm still in the middle of a training session in Yumina. So, yeah, I know, it's been like 3 weeks, but I've still not done it. It's weird. Anyways, actually no, it's probably because I ended up losing a bunch of progress because it closed on me all of a sudden in the middle of a dungeon, and I was like, you know what, I'm done for a while, but anyways, I have failed. All I got was 2 pieces of Anpan. Well, time to look up another thing. Gotta make sure this is educational. Japanese sweet roll. Most commonly filled with red bean paste. Hey, look on the bright side. Nobody stole your sweet roll. I've been having a lot of bad luck with food lately. She looks sadly at the Anpan. They're not bad, but they're a type of bread no one wants. I only got these because I went too late. Her face. Actually, that reminds me. I wanted to just, look at her face on here again. You know, just to check. She timidly offers her bento. Don't take it, man. Then she lowers her head slightly. No, you didn't do anything wrong, Shizuru. She probably feels guilty for taking up my time with those jokes earlier. Sad. Don't worry about it. Don't mind. Really? Asked her face. But, her face says, this will remain a disgrace to my dignity as a warrior. I must do all in my power to atone for it, her face says. It wasn't quite that old-fashioned, but you get the point. Okay, give me a part of your bento, any part you like. She nods. That exchange seems to have reassured her. Now then. I think again. It's not a very good idea to bring a hall monitor with me off campus to buy lunch. In this situation, we must barter. Hey, who's gonna barter for Anpan? For sweet rolls. Just watch. A return to class. Oh, you're not gonna try to barter with the ocean now, are you? Please don't. Nope, it's Kotarou. Hey, Kotarou! Perfect, you haven't eaten yet. Give me your food. Your luck, Kotarou-san. If you'd eaten already, you'd have missed out on a great deal. First, I'll explain things. What do you think of when I say Hokkaido?
Hokkaido, ne.
All I think is, I think it's a place in Japan. Okay, and apparently it's cold. Indeed, it is cold, but what about the food? Yes, that's right. As we all know, the natural northern climate breeds the finest seafood in agriculture. So, I have here an Anpan chocked full of northern blessings. Just look at this thing. The filling was made from nothing but Tokachi beans. The Tokachi fields output the highest quantity and quality that Japanese agriculture has to offer. I was really hoping I could do this all right. Yes. Which means these beans are none other than the northern lands themselves. You want it? Good, then let's make a deal. I'm trying to swap this for part of your lunch, Kotarou.
Nice idea!
And it somehow worked out. Wow. And thus I obtained furikake rice and pickled vegetables. She's in awe.
さすがだ.
Very. No, it's the northern climate. That's impressive. Especially the taste of Tokachi fields.
Hokkaido. Anatorikatashi.
Well, Kotarou should be fine with that Anpan and the rest of her bento. Though they might not go together well. Okay, I could satisfy myself with this. But while I'm at it, let's aim even higher. What, you're going to go even higher? What a terrifying man this Kotarou is. Says her face. I'm starting to have fun dubbing Shizuru's thoughts. Yeah. Hey, Yoshino, don't do it.
Teme. But I get
the feeling he'll fall for it too. Eh? Whoops, he's in a bad mood. Does that mean he doesn't have anything to swap? Are you a dog or a wolf? Pick one. But the point is, he hasn't eaten lunch yet, so he's starving to the point of insanity. He's getting irritable because he's hungry. Cute little Yoshino-kun. Anyway, at times like these, or this, I need to go out of my way to talk in sync with him. Don't listen to me. I'll kill you. Yep. Don't look at this. I'll kill you. Is this called reverse psychology? He'll disobey any order I give him. Guess I have no choice. Here. I take out the Anpan. Ever eaten it? Why don't you give it a try? Wait, are you saying this Anpan is bad for your health? Look, all of the wheat was made in Japan. Come on, smell it. Suha. I open the bag, put it to my nose, and inhale. I try to make Yoshino do the same thing. Incidentally, the image of him doing this is extremely unpleasant. I want to laugh at that so loudly, so badly, but I hold it in for now. Alright, so you can have this for that vegetable sandwich. I'll pay the difference. But still, all the beans came from Tokachi Fields.
100% ta. Sokomade Tokachi ja shouga ne. Motte ikina.
He's not worried about the repercussions at all. And that's how I got this vegetable sandwich. Behold, I am victorious. She looks at me with sparkling eyes and jealous gaze.
Sasuga Kotarou.
I'm surprised how powerful the name Tokachi Fields is. She nods.
Because
he was so hungry. He's just like that. Her confused face says. And that is how I procured my lunch for the day. Okay, now let's go have our exciting lunchtime. I really like her. I prefer you say that with a little more emotion. That's why I like her, though. Shizuru tags along with me to the courtyard. Okay, about here seems good. She nods and takes a newspaper out of her skirt. Does she have a secret pockets under there? What is it, asks her face. Just look around before pulling your skirt up. She looks around, but she doesn't care. I almost saw your panties. See? She doesn't care. Really? I can't tell if she means it's fine because I didn't see them, or it'd be fine even if I did see them. What stupid thing are you worrying about now, Johnny? Says her face. Don't worry about it, it's nothing. Anyway, who's Johnny? Says her face. Well, I did lie about that part, so she seems annoyed about it. She shrugs and goes back to spreading out the newspaper. One piece for me and one piece for her. After thinking for a bit, she moves my newspaper in front of hers.
Kotarou.
She pats it. I guess she wants us to eat facing each other. Since she asked, I sit opposite of her. She smiles wide and sits down in front of me. Okay, let's see what's in here. I open up the bento box I got from Kotarou. Rikako-san special seaweed and bonito furikake rice. This is enough for a meal, but I still want something else. I look towards Chizuru as she pushes the straw into her juice and box, making a leak. No, no, you've got to hold the corner. I take out a tissue and wipe her hands. She lowers her shoulders in shame. Cheer up, it's not like you lost all the juice. You sure? Her sad face says. Come to think of it, I need some other stuff to go with this. She raises her head. She holds out her bento. Some octopus wieners, fried spinach and bacon, and two cherry tomatoes. There's some seaweed for her kaki rice in her hand. These are all lightweight but well-balanced items. Then I'll have some of the octopi. Three octopi board my bento box. Wait, you're sure it's okay for me to take that many? The fully prepared Chizuru-san rests her bento lid on her lap. What's that? Sari kabayaki? I want to know what kabayaki is. Kabayaki. It is a preparation of the unagi eel. It's eel. She looks at me. You want it? No, if you were saving it, then you should have it. She really wants that eel. She's showing her pride now. Well, I didn't want it that badly anyway. Then I'll take some octopi. All of them. Munch. This is good. Whose idea was it to pack meat into a sausage and then smoke it? Whoever it was, these wieners are his legacy. Must be grateful for that great man who made this possible. She looks at the vegetable juice at her feet. Chizuru-san freaks out. Ants are climbing up the side of her vegetable juice. She looks back and forth between me and the ants. What do I do? I'm not sure why she's reacting that badly. Guess I'll help her for now. I pick up the juice. Boo! I blow off the ants. This super strong, muscly lungs. Okay, it's fine now. I hand it back to her. Seems calm now. Then suddenly her face darkens again. Looks like holding the juice took up her free hand. But as she puts it back down, ants will assault it. But her lap is already full with her bento box of canned fish. Drink all of the juice now, and then you don't have to worry about it. She looks desperately at me again. Those eyes make me want to tease her for some reason. Oh, great. Okay, let's do this. I like Kotarou. And I also like her because she's just going with it, apparently. She accepts it and begins eating again. I was expecting her to fight to keep her balance, so this is kind of disappointing. What's that? I tried to make her turn her neck. What is it? She tilts her head. But the juice on her head doesn't budge. She goddamn good balance. No, it was nothing. I think you're gonna have to do some kind of jump scare at her. You sure? She sticks her chopsticks into the sari. Apparently she really likes that. That's such a happy face. It's like a cat lounging in the sunlight. Just seeing it fills my heart with kindness. She happily reaches for something else. After finishing it, she returns to the sari. It's like she's reached the pinnacle of bliss. You like sari that much? She nods. I see. Also, I may just switch to saying eel instead of sari because I'm not even sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Why ask something so obvious? She asks with a rise. Maybe. I guess.
ただこれは一つしかない。一口だけならあげる。
Ah, I can? She puts one piece on top of the rice. Okay, here goes. Munch. Yeah, this is good. But it's just normal canned. Eel. Going with eel. No. I'm sad. I don't think I'm capable of making a face this happy. After she enjoys the aftertaste for a while, she drinks the vegetable juice. Was it good?
とっても美味しい。
She answers with a full smile. Face tells me she must have enjoyed it from the bottom of her heart. She's bad at talking, but she's still good at getting her emotions across. This is what Shizuru is like. And I like her. I hope she is one of the options that I don't have to unlock, because then I'll be very sad. Today's class ends, I look toward Otori's seat. Well, more like I couldn't avoid seeing it. Transfer student Otori-san is reading a book. That impossibly heavy box is at her feet, so she did find it. And she's reading an amazingly huge book from it with one hand. All the boys here seem unable to approach her now that they've seen this bizarre sight. She might as well stand up and say, I'm a power fighter. Though she doesn't seem to care at all. Her eyes zoom across the page. Whisper, whisper, she's a power fighter. Whisper, whisper, is she for real? She's drawing attention. Of course she is. She's only just got here and she's already doing weird things. Hey. Hey, Otori. I get the urge to talk to her.
Hi?
About that book.
Kashimasen yo.
No, I wasn't gonna say it looked interesting. You sure you want to be weirding everyone out?
Donbiki?
Well, you were probably with the boys, but the cuckoo's already calling.
Uh-huh.
Evidently, she didn't even notice it. Come to think of it, she didn't react all that positively to the transfer student fever either. Whoop, I guess she's gonna be part of the group. Soon enough, she reaches a good stopping point, bookmarks it, and closes the book. Ah, I see. So she borrowed them from someone. What was that guy thinking when he gave her these books? Fortunately, the world isn't made to accommodate girls who take completely abnormal actions. In more precise terms, she'd just be an oddity. I hope. Wait a moment. No. Can't think of anyone who had orange hair. Did the guy who lent her these books want her to get in this awkward position? Did Otori want it? What on earth am I thinking? I only met her a few days ago. Worry about people too much. Hey, have any plans this afternoon?
Hi? Nande desu?
Wanna go walking through town? Maybe we can find some cats. Or we can swim in the lake and get seaweed or whatever it was. I was thinking of showing you around town. See you right there.
Hi?
Well, you know, you ended up hating me right off the bat, but I never meant to cause harm or anything. So I want to do something to show I'm sorry about it. I'm a modern youngster, incapable of apologizing to people directly. Good, it worked. Oh, I got through to her, thank goodness.
それとは別に、あなたの軽すぎる口は嫌いです。
Yes. Ah, you mean when I mentioned cherries? I'm definitely sorry about that, but you know, when life gives you cherries...
Yeah!
Complete that statement because I haven't heard of it before. Perhaps shouldn't have said that.
そういうところが嫌いだと言ってるんです!とにかく、今日は他の人と会う約束があるので、一緒には行けません!
She gives me a quick glance, goes oomph, and heads for the door. See you tomorrow then.
そういう軽いところが嫌いだって言ってるんです!
But he just wants to be your friend. She turns toward me while mocking. Ah, Odori.
なんですか?
The door is closed. She hits her head on the door.You should really watch where you're going.
あなたが話しかけてきてるからです。とにかく、今度こそさよなら。
She throws the door open with all her might. The door falls off its track. She desperately tries to keep the door from falling all the way over. It just fell off the rail, so...Always. Keyword. Don't you have somewhere to go? I'll fix it for you, so get going. Ow, 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 you're pinching me? At the end, we fix the door together. Yeah, job well done.
そうですね。本当に疲れました。一体なぜこんなことになっているんですか?
I believe it was because Kotarou talked to you and then you turned around. Don't worry, everyone has their off days when their biorhythms simply aren't in sync for whatever reason.
あなたと会ってからな気がするんですけどね。
That's unfortunate. That's a coincidence. For all we know, everything might be rosy starting tomorrow.
何色のバラですか?
Dunno. I guess red or pink.
とにかく、今日はもう帰ります。
I thought he was making a joke or something there, but I guess not. She walks off. Audrey.
はい?
Weren't you gonna meet someone? She spins around. You forgot all about it.
わ、忘れてたわけじゃありません!
Well, if you say so. Bye, then.
お疲れ、さん。
And Kotaro is probably gonna follow her. I wave to Odori as she leaves, then I get ready to go home myself. Huh? Wait a minute, who could she be meeting? She just transferred here, is there someone in another class she knows already? I wanna know. Oh my goodness. Well, this is obviously a point where I'm gonna need to save.Save right there. And we're gonna follow her. Let's try following her. Normally I just ask who it is, but it's hard to tell if we're even on speaking terms. Yeah, it's kind of true. So I have no choice but to stalk. Okay, maybe not stalk. I shouldn't make a habit out of this, but I only wanted to get a glimpse of this person.I'm assuming that's a character that we already know. I'll follow a fixed distance behind her so she doesn't notice. She walks along, completely unconcerned. But she's wearing that uniform, so she kind of stands out. Does she even know how odd she looks? Actually, she probably doesn't care. She starts going up the stairs. Uh-oh. She could go in either direction when she gets to the next floor. It'd be bad if I lost her here. It's risky, but I'll have to get closer. This is the most perilous part of a stealth mission. She might even see me when she turns around on the landing, so I have to walk around the outside. There's a small puddle in the corner. Someone must have been cleaning the stairs. They forgot to wring out their mop. I have a bad feeling about this, so I move toward the center. She slips and falls. A short pause. She tumbles. Catch. You okay? Successfully grab hold of her. You trip on things a lot. This wasn't my goal, but I'm glad I stalked her. Stalk is such a strong word. I prefer deep love. Unfortunately, no. I was waiting for you to stand up. Kotarou is the one leaning on me. She stands up. Yes? I saw some puddles around here, so watch out for them. Don't say that you were stalking her. Me? I followed you. But if I say that, her opinion of me will plummet even further. The wind called me.
Hi?
Correct response? Just passing through. She's not satisfied with that response. Does she suspect something? Well, something like that. I should probably get out of here quickly. I raise a hand in farewell and turn around.
It's
true, she would've been fine. You're not making much sense, but... Are you saying you're an adult woman so you can handle situations like this on your own?
This?
Well, you know, saying that doesn't make me any less worried about you. Really? She says that angrily and starts climbing the stairs again. Well, I hope she's as self-reliant as she claims to be. What if there are more puddles higher up? I don't know about this one. Stalking her is one thing. But stalking her after she knows you're stalking her, that is true stalking. Eh, keep doing it. I really love babysitting people. I can't help but think this isn't going to benefit me in any way. I start pursuing her again. I knew it. Catch. Hi there. You fall from the sky a lot. She really does need someone to watch her. Don't worry about it. But normal people would be seriously injured or killed by these falls. You're kind of desensitizing me. It's normal to not get broken bones. I see. I'm hoping it if it's normal. Yeah, well, I already made the option. What's help when you don't need it? Mm-hmm. And final stage acceptance. This time she leaves without a word. Jeez, can she really live like this? I'm worried. The wind calls him. Don't worry about it. At least I can get away with blatantly pursuing her up these stairs. You reach the top. Okay, I'm going this way. Where are you going, Ori?
Hi. 3年生の知り合いです.
Is it gonna end up? Wait, but when should it? When would she have met her? That's the question. Oh. Well, that is the only thing you can do on this floor. Which class?
そんなこと聞いてどうするんですか?
I'll graciously escort you there.
いりません.
Then just tell me where it is. Right. So, do you know yet? Yeah, definitely in 1 minute, not like 30. Not that I care, but a second year on this floor really stands out. An odorous in her orange uniform. Everyone staring is starting to get annoying. So what do you mean by find out? See, I called it.
おかなんちゃらです.
Okay. Ult.
そんな感じだった気がします.
So you're after someone in the occult club?
いや、よく知りませんけど.
It's not even clear if that club exists. Are you into that stuff?
どっちかよくわかりませんが. 知り合いがいるので顔を見せに行かないといけないだけです。
Well, Kotarou has a general idea where the room is, so... Who is this person exactly? Is it a man? Is he sexy?
どういう目で私を見てるんですか?女子です!
But I wanna know.
そんなくだらないことをいちいち気にしないでください。
That's the kind of character he is. You won't tell me?
ダメです。
So cold. Well, the occult club used to be in an empty classroom, so we'll probably find out in no time.
そうですか。じゃ、失礼します。
She walks off. By the way, Odori-san.
はい? まだ何か用ですか?
The empty classroom is that way. My point.
知ってます!
That you didn't know. Try not to get sidetracked. I should listen to myself more. True story. Again, she leaves without a word. So are her friends into the occult. She does seem to be doing everything in her power to become unpopular. Oh well. If that's what she wants, I can't stop her. Having no friends is kind of lonely, though. I never transferred myself, but if I had to go to another school without Kotarou or Yoshino, I'd probably try to make some new friends. It'd be lonely otherwise. I'd think everyone would feel the same way. A knock-knock. Wait a moment. This changed. Does this mean that it's by perspective on whose eyes it's looking through? If you do know, don't tell me, because I want to find out for myself. Just in case if there's any special meaning. She knocks on the door. She puts lotion on the skin.
お久しぶりです。迷わずによく来られたわね。
いえ、もちろんです。
Yeah, of course.
ま、大事なのはこれからなんだから、あまり目立たないようにね。
And wow, that is suspicious.
はい。
But hey, it's the correct room. Official words, blunt words without much meaning behind them. It's always like this. Do not form any close relationships during the mission. That's what they always say.
まあ、いいわ。
Uchiri sighs. They're done talking about the mission.
ところで…
あ、はい!
友達はできそうかしら?
Meaningless chatter. It's important to have some of it from time to time.
友達…ですか?
She doesn't understand. She hesitates to answer as if she's thinking of someone. That's never happened before, they both know that. Both of them were surprised at her reaction. But since she was thinking of someone... I'm confused. Is it... How many people are in the room right now? I need to know that. Is there somebody that's just like sitting there and being quiet, watching this, or... She asks that question. It's like that neither of them knows the true meaning of the word friend. But they might learn it soon.
なるようになると思います。そうね。
That's all anyone can do. I'm going to rely on the assumption that he's going to be making it home soon, because once it's the next day, I'm going to end this part. Exclamation point! The wind's picking up. Kazumatsuri is surrounded by forest, so trying to speak too fast. So sometimes the air descends in a random place and starts up unpredictable winds. This seems to be one of those days. The wind gets stronger and stronger. It's on par with a small typhoon. Some women have to hold their skirts down. Wow. This is pretty intense. I can feel it pushing against my body. A sheet between two buildings tears and starts flopping around. Someone screams, along with a very slight otherworldly sound. Then I see it. Something falls from a tall building. Multiple things. First one hits the ground, a few meters in front of me. Makes an unfamiliar noise as it shatters. Okay, that was just glass breaking, that's... But a hand in front of my left eye. Feel a little pain in my palm right after I do that. Tiny object seems to have hit me at high speed. Piece of flower pot. Fell from one of the buildings. The soil spills out onto the ground and the ripe fruit looks stepped on. Several more flower pots fall in the wind. You should probably get away from, the buildings. It's maybe 7 total. One's making a beeline for my head. Yeah, you should definitely move. Dots? So suddenly my body tenses up. If I calm down and move, I can evade it. But there's no time to calm down. So, I don't really want to do this, but... I never wanted to use it again, but... I don't have a choice. What's he doing? Kotarou? Deep in my heart, I think of it. A glowing fluid pouring into my body and mind. Like oil in a machine. It revolutionizes my being. Just one drop, that's enough. My vision immediately widens. That glowed. Normally, when humans focus on something, their vision narrows. I forcibly remove that rule. I can both concentrate and take in more information at the same time. The density of information I process skyrockets. The world looks transparent, like the resolution increased. Everything happens in slow motion. I move. I predict that 3 of the flower pots will crush the toes of a young boy nearby. The boy's looking up, frozen. Everyone react that way. I had to wipe out that shock with a drop of oil. I grasp the stunned boy and push him out of danger. Thank you? It's nothing. I'll leave the confused boy there and leave quickly. Police car shows up. Someone must have called it. I don't feel like being interrogated right now. Wait, why? It's flower pots. Why would you be interrogated about them? So? I slip into a back alley. Time to start running. I rush home. I'm pretty far from where it happened now. But my uniform stands out. I can't relax yet. My enhanced senses are making me uncomfortable. That was all I could do in that instant. My eyes feel numb, kind of like when you read in a poorly lit room and someone turns the lights on without warning. I'm just gonna have to get used to this. It'll take a bit of time before I become Superman. Can't go back there, so... Really? Giving me a map thing now? You know what this means, right? Okay, I'm gonna save here. Let's see what we have. And I don't lie, there's nothing. What's well, not even like a arrow pointing back the way that he came, and then him being like, in a very serious voice, "No, I can't go back there." I don't sense or see anyone around, so I shouldn't have to worry about being seen. Oh, there's another map. What, is it just gonna be like basically the same thing over and over again? Oh my god, this one's really long. That's how I search. Okay, apparently there's nothing. Keep going. Something's not right. This is Ali. Ah, good, he notices. Still looks familiar. Well, I'm still even if he's saying that it's basically gonna be the same thing, and we're both aware, I'm still gonna check. I'm not seeing anyone at all. There has to be someone else here at this time of day. This is no ghost town. Complete. Okay. Well, guess that means there really isn't anything here. Keep going. Something doesn't feel right. Huh? This place doesn't end. I look at a telephone pole. There should be an address written on it. Tetsu Sato? Hardly ever have a reason to come to this area. Guess I got lost somehow. There's no one here. I'm the only one on the street. I know there were loads of people around when I went in the alley. I go around a random corner. Still no signs of life. Something feels weird. All I did was find an empty street, but... some otherworldly... Hi. After rounding several corners, I bump into a suspicious-looking person. Yeah. Oh. Crap, I made a weird noise. Walk past him. You're not gonna... Well, okay. The hood covers most of his face, so I can't tell if he's a man or a woman. And it wasn't a sweatshirt hood. Why is he wearing a robe? Looks like something a wizard might wear. Is he dressing up for some reason? I feel like I fell down a rabbit hole somewhere. Yeah. Is it for some Harvest Festival event? It's certainly possible. Harvest Festival has enough costume attendees that it almost feels like Halloween. I tell myself he must be one of those guys, but then... he stops and stares at me. How can he stare at you through that hood? It's covering their entire face. Something feels wrong, so I quickly round the next corner. I know superpowers are real. So ghosts, curses, aliens, and... umas might be too. It'd be so nice if I could rule out all supernatural phenomena. Then I wouldn't have to be afraid of ghosts anymore. Well, that explains why he's... That explains why he's so freaked out that he basically has a ghost with him. It's because he's aware of the supernatural. Also, yes, I am semi-ignoring the fact that he just activated super adrenaline or whatever and stuff. But if even one of them exists, there's no way to know which of the others are real too. That's why I'm interested in that stuff. I need to know for sure. I need to check every single one. I focus on moving my legs. I'm almost jogging now. I realize I'm back on the main street. Still no people. No one's here. No cars pass by. At this time of day, that's just weird. Yeah. I look up. A gray sky throwing down dull light. Common sense can't explain why there's no sun and no clouds up there. It's just a coincidence. No, man, it's not. I just stumbled across a weird moment in time when no people or cars happen to be around. As soon as a single car passes by, I'll know it's fine. Then a black shadow appears in the corner of my eye. Hmm? I stand still. It's a black dog. That is disturbing. I hope it's not a person or a car, but at least it's alive. I want to trust it. It's black for one thing, and then it's a dog. If it was a black cat, I'd trust it more. I start to feel reassured, but then doubt covers my heart again. It's a very strange dog. It doesn't bark or run around. It just looks at me. If I knew that this game had battle mechanics, I'd be like, oh, is this the first fight? It's about 30 meters away. That thing's huge. Yeah, you should definitely not be here. Definitely one of the larger breeds. In and of itself, that's not strange at all. But the fact that he's not on any sort of leash isn't normal. Someone isn't gonna like that. Move away from the dog. I feel like it'll attack if I run, so I try walking as slow as possible, but I can't stop myself from jogging a little. I turn around after a short while. The dog's about 20 meters behind me. Pretty sure it was 30 before. You've got to be kidding me. I walk a little further, then check in. Dude, I think you need another drop of oil. The back of my neck is starting to feel numb. The dog's eyes hold no emotion as they gaze at me. Are dogs normally that expressionless? There's no emotion in them at all. And if he sees me as an enemy, he should be barking or growling. Following me silently is just... I need to shake him. This is getting kind of disturbing. I turn a corner and instantly run. I run as fast as I can. I turn another corner right away. Head for the next branch of the road without losing any speed. I change direction as many times as possible to throw him off. How do you like that? Oh, hey, how you doing, doggy? The dog's standing 5 meters behind me. He isn't even panning.
What?
5 meters. Feels like he's right on top of me. 5 meters. That is 100 centimeters, right? 100 centimeters would be about that length. So that's from me to the wall? Yeah, I'd be kind of freaked out. Any four-legged carnivore could leap on me from this distance. No way. If he attacks me, what do I do? Will I be able to throw him off? That dog looks like it weighs 50 to 60 kilos. Well, at least it's not a giant panther. It should be stronger than a human of the same weight. Probably can't beat it. Probably would have gone all out in the past, but I can't do that now. What is he? But I can't run either. Also, is it just me, or did the arrow move slightly? I'm gonna have to check. Actually, wait. No, I want to know right now. Okay, save. Here. This is kind of... No, this is important. Come on, guys. Just anyone. Sure, we'll go here. This is important. It did! It did move. It did move, guys. Okay. It's an animal. It's faster than a human. I search for footholds in my range of vision. Where? It moved again. Calm down. Also, I think the dog disappeared. Okay, that should do. I set my objective. Start moving to the right slowly, hoping the dog won't react. Then the dog takes one step forward. It's definitely after me. I start running, then jump immediately. Leap onto a metal business dumpster on the side of the road. Then use that dumpster to make another jump. Toward the wall. Come on. Get up there! Yes, I'm on it. I run another few steps along the wall, then jump to a second floor window in a nearby building. Doa? I freak out as I almost slip off, but I manage to hang on to the window frame. Way too close. I would have fallen if I missed that. The window's open. I climb inside. Heh, take that. Look down into the alley. Is the dog not there? The black dog looks up at me angrily, but eventually he walks off. What the hell was that thing? Anyway, I'm safe for now. When I calm down, something feels off. My thigh is hot for some reason. It's a natural heat, like a machine was implanted there for something. Did I leave it on? I ended up using a lot of it with the flower pots. I must have unconsciously used some more when I was running earlier. So that has to do with whatever his power is? But then it said other. So... be nice if I knew if these symbols meant anything. So I could give more insight to my thoughts. That was dumb. This is what happens when I lose my cool. But I might not have made the jump without it. When I leave the building, I see plenty of people and cars on the street in front of me. This makes no sense. Was that whole thing a dream? Well, I'm back to my world now. I sigh. By the time I get home, it's dark. There's a note on the table. Apparently, my parents came back during the day. Then they left this note before going out again. To Kotarou, we won't be coming home for a while. Just take care of the house, Mom and Dad. Okay. This is normal. You know what's not normal, though? Because they work such terrible hours, I get to live however I want. No complaints. If they just gave a bit more allowance. I find some stuff in the fridge that wasn't there this morning, so I have that for dinner. And now it's time for bed. Thought about sleeping in another room, but using my parents' bedroom would just be weird. And the living room is so big, it feels even more vulnerable to spectral attacks. Curling up in my own blanket is the most reassuring option. For some reason, my blanket feels like it ward off ghosts, as long as you don't look under it. I decide to sleep with the lights and the TV on. My only means of resistance. Ghosts probably don't like bright, lively places. Darkness is dangerous. Darkness makes more of them appear in video games. I've never slept with the lights on before, but I have to try it. Okay, let's sleep. Ha ha. I'm gonna have fun dreams, and there's nothing you can do about it. Hit the hay as cheerfully as I can. The lights and the TV turn off. I leap out of bed, stick the wall, and flick the switch several times. It won't work. Blackout? Did a fuse blow? Can't be a ghost, right? Did they just trap me in the dark? Locked room in the darkness, that's a bad combination. That'll make the darkness even more powerful? Can't stay here. I try to escape to the hallway, but the door won't open. He's just having a fairly bad day. Open up, dammit. Why won't you open? I know 8-bit games do this all the time, but... open! Save me! Kotarou! I seek help from a girl in my terror. I scream as loud as I can, but no one comes to help. Of course not, no one else is here. Even in ghost movies, people will usually get attacked after being locked up somewhere by themselves. Okanda... try to say, okay, the veranda, but my tongue moves too fast. I leap toward the glass door on the other side of the room. I'm on the second floor, but I can jump down from here. It won't open no matter how hard I pull. It won't even shake. It's like it's frozen. Then I'll have to pick up a chair and swing it against the glass. Feels like I hit a solid wall of diamond. The recoil makes me stagger. And the glass didn't break at all. A spectral field? There's no doubt in my mind that strong spectral barriers can repel any physical attack. I've seen it a lot in horror movies. Cheeking them or hitting them with a bat won't do a thing. The most violent or reckless types get killed first. They get locked in spectral terror rooms. Exclamation point. Seems like everything suddenly got darker. I could feel the ghost preparing to attack me. No. Suddenly, the lights come on. The ghost missed his chance? Maybe it was just a blackout. That's right. Ghosts aren't real. My room is covered with footprints. It's disturbing. Including the ceiling of the walls. As if someone walked all over the room with muddy feet. No human can walk on walls like that. I have a really strong sixth sense. I recite a line I think I heard somewhere before, then faint. Really? Well, this was definitely... oh, hey, we're gonna be meeting her, finally. Also, I just noticed that they have weird uniforms. Autosave complete. Woo. Cool, he's at school. That's good to know. Oh, also. But the meter didn't go back. Interesting. Quite interesting. I kind of wonder I'm trying to remember about in the opening. Like at the very beginning. When it was like talking about something where he was like, I have nothing or whatever. And then he was thinking about like doing stuff over or something like that. I'm just wondering what if there was a meter there, what it looked like. Questions. To be answered another time though. Unfortunately, not too soon. Probably. Anyways, see you in the next part. Bye.